and thank you, organizers, sir. Organizers, okay. So, actually, this is the study, the part of our ongoing project, glacier and climate. In this, in that project, we are monitoring around 6 glaciers of Chandra basin, Western Himalaya. So, we have one more component like debris cover. As our director, sir, Dr. Ravi Chandran, he has already mentioned zone 3. Debris cover glaciers are retreating faster in the Himalayan region. So, here I will just explain why it is melting and why what is the reason behind it. So, in the background, you see this is the picture. This is a glacier actually, a debris cover glacier. Here the thickness of the debris cover is varying from 1 meter to from snout to just like top, it will be in centimeters. So, there is a pro-glacier lake and this photo was taken by Dr. Rasik Ravindra. Batal gaye sir. So, going to the next. So, as it is already explained by speakers, the Himalayan glaciers are very important for the sustainability of the this Hindu Kush Himalayan region. They are retreating with the various like different rates in the different regions. Somewhere they are advancing, somewhere they are due to surging events, and somewhere they are like in the stagnant phase. Somewhere the retreat is very fast. So, okay. So, whenever we speak about glaciers, so the first picture which comes in our mind is a clean ice and blue ice, like white island, white land. But the situation is different. Here I will show you some examples. This is our Indian glacier, Gepang glacier. You see the left and right side. This is just debris, normal, like thin debris. It is coming from the this cliffs, rock cliffs. And yeah, go back. And this is just like one glacier, the debris which is transferred from accumulation zone to this ablation zones. And this is the basin glaciers. And they are the like entire, it has a length of 27 kilometer. The first like from is now to up to 15 kilometer, it is covered with the thick debris. And this is that there, you can see the, this is just like valley view. And this is from one like central flow of the Balasagiri glacier. Again, this is one more glacier. This is Gepangad glacier. This is one channel of the Gepangad glacier. This is Samudra Tapu. This is a moraines which is just like formed through the debris movement from this side. Okay. As per our satellite data analysis, one of the authors, they have like mapped the debris cover glaciers of the entire world except excluding this Greenland and Antarctica. Around 4.4% of the entire world, it is just covered by the debris cover glacier. And most of the region, like high concentration has been obtained in high mountain region, like our this here Andes and this Alps, and they are also in Himalayan region. So, and here you are also, you can see this is this high concentration in the Asian region and this our Andes and other Caucasus mountains. Okay, in HKH Himalaya, the most of the debris is just found in the ablation zone, and the distribution is, you see here the like relative area in the HKH region. You see the scale here, the white part is representing the less amount and darker part is just the highest higher concentration, and more concentration is there in Western Himalaya. Here also you see the relative ice mass stored under debris. This is also very high in Western Himalaya, and the ice under debris cover is also very high in Western Himalaya. So Western Himalaya is very like critical for this study. Okay, and also here you see, as per the RCP's region climatic models, they are telling the in this region, Central Himalaya, East Himalaya, Hindu Kush and Karakoram, Western, it is going to increase more. And the studies of this region, early studies, they are telling this debris cover glaciers are retreating faster as per the clean glacier. There are some other people, they are also telling the same thing. And there are recent studies through EC mode, they are telling there is no like changes with the debris cover. So there is just like there are some confusion. Is it seriously, is it retreating or not retreating? So we had done some studies with our it was opening properly. Okay, it's okay. Leave it. Yeah. So here in this study, me with our Sharma sir and Patel sir, under the guidance of Rasik sir, we have done some pilot study in the Batal glacier, and what we had observed that the melt under debris, it was just reduced by 10 times here, and we have developed a regression equation for the same, and predicted the melt rate of the Batal glacier in case of in the absence of debris, and which compared with the obtained result, which showed that the debris cover like reduced the ablation 10 times if it is more than 1 meter. Actually, this is the study area of Chandra basin. Here is some glaciers which our doctor sir, he has already shown in his slides. So this is our glacier. This is our like thermal data loggers which we have, me and my team, we have installed in the Barasigri and Batal, and one more glacier is Kunjamata. This is our Himath station where we have all the facilities, and this is our okay, what happens exactly in debris cover? This is just like one glacier and schematic diagram, how debris like comes from this surrounding mountains and glacier, how it is getting transported from accumulation to like ablation zone. It will come through the surface and in glacial and subglacial paths, and here and how it melts. You just imagine if it is just bare ice, so the sun rays will fall in the ice and it will start direct melting. But in the case of the debris, the energy will transfer to the debris layer, then this ice will start melting. So we need to know exactly what is happening with this debris cover. So for the in this regard, what we have done, we have fixed with some this is the Barasigri glacier and this ice cliff, and this is our thermal data logger. This is a tiny tank thermal data logger with high precision. But before installing, actually in this region we have installed 5 thermal data loggers. So before installing, we have done the validation in the our Himans site. So we kept all the thermal data loggers for half an hour observation, and we checked with our Campbell, our precise instrument. We found that we high accurate in the 0.04 like a difference with the all the probes and this data logger. So after that, we fixed this all the this thermal data logger in the field. This is from Barasigri, this is also from Barasigri, and this is from Kunjumata, that is from Batal glacier. So one tiny tech data logger, it has 2 probes. Okay sir. Yeah, fine. So just first we fix the surface, and second one the interface zone, and then one more at Batal. What we did, we have fixed one more probe at the like intermediate zone. Okay, so this is general description of that thermal data logger and debris sample to check the debris quality of drop types and debris samples. And this is the methodology which we used for the debris cover assessment. First, we have just checked the what is the debris cover extent and thickness in the Chandra basin, and what kind of debris it is, means rock properties. And second, we have installed thermal data loggers to observe surface temperature. Then finally, to estimate the thermal quality of this thermal properties of this debris cover debris layer, we use this melt rate and this surface temperature. Melt rate we got through the our stakes measurement, mass balance data sets. Okay, so this is actually the slides of surface temperature, which is just like annual, and this is our accumulation season and ablation season. And we checked this our average data set at different altitudes. The observed temperature was in annual it was 0 point, in different altitudes it was varying from 0.2 to minus 4.9 degrees centigrade. And at ablation zone, if you see the accumulation ablation zone, it was huge difference. It was in minus 3.8 in accumulation season, but in ablation it was 6.9. So surface temperature it was varying too much. And here we have compared correlated our obtained data set with the our meteorological observation, especially air temperature. And we got a very high correlation. So means with the obtained data sets. and this is our thermal resistance which we have estimated through the obtained observations. So what we got, the debris layer with a thick debris layer at the lower heights, it was having a high thermal resistance compared to the in the higher altitudes. So it shows that the region which is high thick debris, it allows it restrict the energy movement from surface to the interface zone. So the this, it will just protect the glacier to melt. And here in higher altitudes, 4800 MSL and 5200, there the resistance is very low. So the thing is that if the debris thickness is very low, so energy will get stored in the that debris, and it immediately it's transferred into the ice, so the melting will be high. So this is the thing here. So this was a general summary that
you have summarized already your findings now.
Yeah, that's
thank you very much.